So this is the 7th of the 13 episodes of the best Bleach episodes that have been voted by the Japanese people and the West, maybe, I don't truly know that. But yes, we are on the 7th episode preparing for the Thousand Year Blood War arc. And this week we have Ichigo versus Aokira towards the end fight of that battle. Now granted, it's a bit of a slow one, you know, because it is towards the end of that fight, but a great fight nonetheless. And I'm wondering whether they're going to be introducing the other two before that in later episodes, and I kind of hope it's not the case. Again, I know it's voted, I know that, you know, it's got to do it in order, but it'd be a bit weird if you just show this fight and then the others in non-order. But hey, that's me. But anyway, I hope you enjoy the episode, and yeah, click and subscribe and see these every Sunday/Monday, and yeah, we'll get straight into it. Let's go. And it starts right off in the Aranker arc with Yami. So, what episode is this? Already in the Aokira versus Ichigo? Oh, epic opening. Love this. Not many people are like, oh, I prefer opening 13. But opening 12 is a bit of a banger. And I was under the impression when I first watched this for the first time, is I always thought that the voice actor of Orihime was singing this, because there was a bit of a rumor going around. But yeah, I liked it because I always thought that that was the case. And you know what? In my little own head canon, I'm going to believe that that is the case. But I know it's not. Yeah, banger. 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 So we're kicking off the 7th episode of the Bleach best episodes with Ichigo versus Aokira, which I'm very happy about, because this definitely deserved to be up there. However, there were 3 episodes of this, so I wonder if the other two will be involved. And it'd be really weird to watch it out of order, but great fight. Yeah! Grab that motherfucker's head, bro! Sheesh! Come on! I love that, because it's just it's a little callback to what Aokira did to Ichigo. Love that. And this as well. Now, this wasn't really shown in the anime that much, but in the manga you see like a human hand going to like his Vasa Lordae hand, which could be attributed or argued that that's his instant regeneration. Little fun tidbits. It's hard explaining while watching at the same time sometimes. Yeah, love that. Foot on the face, big Cero. You love it because it's, you can tell like it's a very animalistic fight. And Hollow Ichigo at this point is just acting like an animal. So, love that. Oh, don't tell me the majority of the episode we're going to get. Rarudabon. It's a character we don't see that much of, surprisingly. We don't really know what he is in terms of like his relation to the Espada. Which, obviously, he isn't an Espada. And we don't really have a unit of him in BBS, surprisingly. Don't know why. Is Chad going to do anything besides make a big smoke cloud? Oh, he beat some minions. I love the sound effects of the sonido as well. So I hope that they keep that in. Okay. She created the ice wall. Okay. And then let me guess. He breaks down the wall and then Renji comes in with the Taiho. If memory serves correctly. This would be the smart plan, though. There we go. Yeah, there we go. Drag him. Come on. Yes, sir. Oh, he made more? Oh, come on. You could have self-destructed on that. Surely. But then again, you don't know how strong he is. Because I was about to say, a bunch of minions really pushing down Zabimaru like that. But okay, sure. What's all this then? What's all this? What you cooking? Ah, you've stuffed it, mate. You've stuffed it. Those tree branches. Yep. Froze. Good luck regenning, bro. I mean, there's not really much to say. It's just good tactics, and it's expected from Rukia, to be honest. She's always been a very interesting and good tactician. She's not really ever been a bit of a meathead. And come on, who doesn't love hearing Rukia speak? We all love hearing Rukia speak. She got a beautiful voice. Raw. Okay, Yami. Oh, okay. So that's how Rarudabon got clapped, truthfully. Is Yami doing his bits. Yeah, it's a shame the anime censored that the way it did, because it made Jammy's attacks seem a lot more brutal. But he is, in fact, a meathead. Oh yeah, because he gets angry, doesn't he, and he grows. So it would make sense that he has it in his standard form as well. That's why he probably looks a lot bigger. Oh, yeah, and that's the aftermath of the Sero to the face from Hollow Ichigo on Okiora. So that's cool that they're showing two parallels of like what's happening at the same time type of thing. Look at that lighting. That's beautiful. And if I remember correctly, does the anime show it? No, it senses it a little bit. You can see the arm's gone, but... Oh, no? Yep. Okay, cool. I was about to say, in that shot, you can see just half the body gone. They did some weird little censorships in this. Like, they'll show Okiura's arm, like, kind of be cut off, but they won't show Uryu's. And is that because he's a demon and not a human? So that's where the regulations lie in TV? Who knows? But they do some weird edits, that's for sure. Oh, here we go. That's enough, Kurosaki. You don't need to do any more. If you carry on, you won't be human anymore. Yeah. And the fact that he's not doing it straight away is good. Because it shows that there's a part of him still fighting inside of him mentally, so... Yeah. Didn't really win that one, did you, mate? Fair play for going up to him, though. Ah, yeah, that's not good. And Okiora unironically saves the day. Or saves Uryu's life, for sure. The Horn of Salvation being chopped off is surprising. Especially which side of the Horn of Salvation gets chopped off as well. Is the one that deactivates his full hollow. I don't know if it's intentional, foreshadowing or not. Ayo, or he may have got the shoulders out, boys. Woof. One thing that I've noticed through reacting to these episodes, there's a lot of emotional scenes and you don't really appreciate it until you do like a rewatch and you pay attention. But the music really shows that direction really well. Instant regeneration, baby. Yeah, because it's like everything that was like turning him into like a vassal all day, like the long hair and the white plating on him is just like gone up and then just like turned into spiritual energy and then like zoomed back into his soul. So is that instant regeneration? Potentially. Conversion, white's powers converted into fill in the hole, maybe also symbolic. He's still alive, Ichigo. Oh no, he's looking at Uryu. Look what you did to Mans, bro. Look what you did. Yeah, you want to pull that out and have Orihime just patch him up right quick because, yeah, it's not a good thing to have in your body, mate. You know? I always did find, like, the little stick leg on Okiura funny. Yikes. Yeah. I don't know, they could have added a lot more pain in Uryu's voice there. Like an actual scream or something, because that's not... Then again... Can Uryu use Blue Vein at this point? Probably not, but could probably lessen the pain that he feels, maybe. Yeah, so this is where he says to Okiura that like he wants him to chop off his leg and arm so the match is fair, as he didn't think it was deserving of him to win a fight this way. Which, I don't know. I've criticized the mindset of this many times in videos, but I get it. You can't really feel, it's Rukia's, you know, kind of expression of the eyes of the victor, right? And Ichigo didn't have the eyes of a victor as he, there it is, yeah, man's dying. But it's a pride thing of battle, and look, you're fighting like a really powerful person. But then again, if you are going to fight Aizen and you can't beat Okiura on your own means, I also understand the frustration. But take advantage if your enemy's dying, you know? Or at least grant him his wish of killing him when he's on the verge of, like, literally turning to ash. From narrative standpoint, it's good for Okiura to try and understand how humans think as well. And this is where the Okihime shippers get their little thrill. Oh, the reflection in the eye is a nice touch. And this is really symbolic as well, because it's like he believes that feelings come from the heart. Like, if I rip out your chest, will you still have these feelings? Or if I ripped out your eyes, you know, are they located there? Where are these feelings, or where is this heart that you speak of? And the heart is essentially in the hand. I forgot from the top of my head where this ideology came from, but he's reaching out to her hand. And that's where the heart is. But hey, maybe that gives you guys an excuse to comment in the comment section down below and reference what the hand and heart thing is. And yeah, Okiura dies. And does he go to hell? Does he get reborn into the world of the living? Does he get reborn into the Soul Society? We don't know. The ending. Banger. Banger ending. I actually love watching this in like frame by frame to see all like the references in the background. Banger. It's cool to see all the Iran cars without the masks on as well. This was a really... Even though like most of it's still frames, it's nice. I don't know. It's a nice direction. It's something different, something creative. You get to see what type of personalities these characters are if they were in the real world, so that's cool. So is Okiura supposed to be a detective? Chat, foreshadowing! Foreshadowing, potentially. And it's a good excuse to show off Kubo's fashion designs, as he likes to do. And will we get this in the Blood War arc? Who knows? The Quincy Encyclopedia. Again, I hope you enjoyed that episode. Again, a bit of a slow episode and a bit of a... I guess it's an ending of an episode that I feel doesn't really fit TV, personally, because of all the adverts and whatnot. So, yeah, it was a good episode. I quite liked it. Again, the whole hand and heart ideology going on there really gives you a perspective into Okiura as a whole and Ichigo's mentality while he's breaking out of White, and maybe some foreshadowing with the Horn of Salvation, you know, the little details that we may not have noticed. But overall, you know, again, we had the Yami stuff, but the majority of the episode to me was a lot of flashbacks and a lot of retellings of things. And to be honest, yeah, it makes sense. So I mean, it's supposed to be the end of Ichigo versus Okiura, so I would imagine that if they didn't have all those flashbacks and whatnot, it would go into another fight, which would probably end off the episode quite weirdly. So I'm okay with this. It was a good episode and I quite enjoyed it. Not the quite ugga bugga fight I was expecting this week, but you know what, it's a great episode nonetheless, and I can see why it was voted. So we'll just have to see in what we get next week, to see if we continue this fight in backwards order, or we'll just see if we get another episode entirely. But I feel like this isn't the end for this fight, so titling this video is going to be extremely weird for me. But if you like the video, please click like. I know some of you are really actually hitting me up saying you appreciate these, so please show some love and support by liking and commenting the video. With that being said, you guys of course have this fire damage enhancement, and as always people, peace out.